Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. And in my this particular video, I am going to show you another very interesting way to count total number of holes present in a binary image. Okay, so what algorithm I have shown you previously, that is using BW label, right? So for the experiment purpose, I have taken this particular image IMShowX. Okay, and let me just show you the image once. And here we can see 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, total 10 holes are present. Now what we have done to count that, we have basically taken complement of this particular binary image, so complement of IM binarize X. And then what we have done, we have basically labeled that image using BW label. And as a result, you can understand easily that if we take binary complement, let me just show you the complemented image. Okay, so here selected this part and run. Okay, now you can see there are, if you count the objects, there is white parts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right? And along with that, this particular background, okay? So now, if you apply BW label, all the white parts will be labeled, but we don't want the background part because background part is not whole. Okay, so what we will do, after labeling we are subtracting one value, right? And that is what is our output. So let, if I just run this particular part, see, I'll be getting 10 as answer. All right, now this same algorithm we can do using IM fill or region filling algorithm in case of binary image also. And how? See, the idea is very simple. Let me just show you IMShowX. Now this is my image. Okay, now you just think, if we able to fill all the holes, then this all the small objects will be compact, no holes will be present, and then we can subtract this particular original image from the image, which is basically outcome after filling all the holes. As a result, what will happen, only difference will present in the whole parts. Okay, and remember, I have told you this concept also while discussing the arithmetic operation in images, that to find the difference in between two image, we can use IM subtract, or basically simply give minus sign and you will be getting subtracted result. So using that, we can achieve total number of holes again. Okay, so let us check IMShowX. Let me just remove y equal to IM binarize of X. We are converting to binary image, and then we will fill that. So F equal to IM fill, the inbuilt function present in MATLAB. I am using IM fill y comma holes. Okay, and then after that, what I have to do, will subtract. Okay, so F equal to F minus X. Okay, and then on this we can apply labeling, right? So let us apply labeling A B equal to BW label F. Okay, and display will be directly B. Okay, and let me just show you the images. So here I will write figure IM show Y. Alright, and here if I just copy this particular part, and here let me just paste, and here also let me just paste. Here this is my one F, this is my another F, and yeah. Now let's hope that this code should work. If I just run, see some error we are getting. Let us check what comma integers, same class integers can only combine with integers of same class or scalar doubles. Okay, let me check what is the problem. Okay, so F is logical where X is unsigned integer. Okay, oh sorry, this will be actually Y. Y is our binary image, right? So now let's hope that this code should work. Control A, evaluate selection. See, we are getting 10 here in command window. Here we are getting 10. Now let's try to understand what actually happening. Okay, so this is our original in binary image. After performing region filling algorithm, we are getting this one, right? Now when you are subtracting this particular original image from this particular image which you are getting after performing IM fill, that is after performing region filling algorithm, we are getting only the whole parts. And now simply we can apply labeling. So as a result, all these particular holes which are basically white objects present in this particular subtracted output will be basically object, and that all will be labeled. And you can count how many objects are present using the second argument of label, that is AB equal to BW label F. From B we'll be getting the idea, right? So this is the simplest concept how you can extract the holes from a binary image using IMFill, or BWFill also you can use, but as I have shown you that better to use IMFill instead of BWFill, right? So this is all for this video. And you may think, why I am using this particular inbuilt function IMFill instead of using our own code which I have shown you. Remember, if you have seen my earlier video where I have discussed our own code, that is applicable for only one hole. Okay, that is, suppose, let me zoom this. Suppose I am considering this particular part. Here only one hole is present in this particular whole image. If you consider this as one image, then in this case our that own code will work properly. But if there are multiple holes present, like here, then for each holes we need to apply the same algorithm which we have used or which we have written using our own approach. Okay, that we need to apply for all the individual holes. And for that, what we need to detect first where hole is appearing, so the algorithm complexity will increase. Okay, you can write, it is not like that, it is not possible to write because the MATLAB software developers have written that in the backend. That's why we are able to use the encapsulated format directly IMFill, right? It is possible to write, but that algorithm complexity will increase. So that I am showing using IMFill, because here our interest is not the filling of holes. We need to do something more than filling. Filling is the secondary part. We are using filling as one part of our whole algorithm, where our actual aim is to count the total number of holes, right? So to get the filling of the algorithm, you can write the concept from the scratch by your own. But if you want to do in some application related project, then you can go with the inbuilt function also, because that will decrease the total number of lines in your code also, and as a result debugging will be far easier, right? So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.